I'm Natasha St. Jess from St. Tobias J.
This is Demirte.
This is YTH Stick.
Young Ty. This is your boy Wax and Cold.
Fiji Diamond, man.
And I'm tuned into the session
at ReJuv'Nation.com.
CT stands up.
It's the RJN Sessions at ReJuv'Nation.com. It's your boy Timeless Trail. You're my magnificent co-host.
Thank you. It's so weird sitting in front of you like this.
Yeah, man. We got that facial.
I don't know about this. Next week I might be back in my seat.
Got A60 Beauty in house. We got the man, huh? This guy got me jumping on my seat right now, man. The kid Mike Flowz, what up, baby?
It's lit. It's litty. You already know.
What's good, man? How you doing today?
Everything is good. Everything. Like I said, nobody ain't going to listen to you complain anyway. Everything is good.
Word.
Blessed.
Word. Blessed to be here. I'm glad to have you here, man.
No, I'm glad you got me here. Man, we long time.
Yo, man, we got to talk, man.
Yes, sir.
First off, before we get into any conversation, let's do the... You got a question today?
You know, when I say that, I mean it's kind of
boring. I got a question.
Let's hear your question. What's your question?
The usual questions, I'll let you do them, but we got Mike Flowz in the house.
Okay.
Man. He need that. He's into it. Like he knows what he's in tune with what's going on and everything.
That'll put me on the spot.
Definitely. Okay. Now you let me hear an exclusive track. I ain't gonna say no names.
Okay, word.
But damn, that shit was fire. Let's start by saying that.
Word.
But in there, you know, you just dropped a couple hints about, like, this violence going on in these streets,
man.
Oh,
yeah.
And I ain't talking about violence against us and each other. I'm talking about violence against the cops versus the people.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
So what do you think we can do to change that as a community?
What I feel like it's time, what I'm trying to do with my music, basically I'm trying to start this revolution. Like, because it's going to take somebody. Like,
right.
My favorite rapper right now, J. Cole, I feel like he the front runner in doing that right now. But J. Cole is a little less aggressive than I am naturally as a person.
Yeah.
Naturally as a person, I got a little bit of aggression behind me that, feel me, I put out in my records and I put out words for people to say. It's going to take somebody like me to just let these people know, like, all right, now it's time to put your foot down because what they're doing is not legal.
Right.
You feel me? Like, getting shot for not doing anything is not legal.
Right.
They getting off for it because it keeps happening because we keep letting it happen.
Yeah.
Like, somebody got to stop letting it happen. Exactly. Like, that's the only way it's going
to
stop.
Now, to go off of that, you're not afraid of the precautions and repercussions that come with it.
Man.
I'm saying.
Man, I don't fear anybody that bleeds like me. The only person, I'm a God-fearing man. That's how I came on this earth. I was raised in a church.
Yeah.
I am not worried about what could come from that, because honestly, any rebuttal I have for that is positivity. You gave me a First Amendment right, freedom of speech.
Right.
I can talk.
Yeah.
I can say what I want.
Uh-huh.
Y'all tried this back in the day with NWA, and it didn't work because they still got their records off.
Yeah.
Right. So it's not going to work now.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Especially not now. Right.
It's not going to work now.
What you think, A60?
Nah.
Wow. Let me say something about what happened to me this weekend.
Oh,
really fast.
Shit.
Oh, man. Well, it didn't happen to me. It happened to my boyfriend. So he got pulled over. He had the, shout out to Splash, he had the Homicide Hartford hat in his window. He got pulled over.
Shout out Splash, All City, that whole movement.
Listen, so he got pulled over. Mind you, my boyfriend was on his phone. It was on speaker. He wasn't on the phone. But I was on the phone with him. So he told me, like, I'm about to get pulled over. I was close by. So I was like, let me just drive over there and see what's going on. So, of course, because he's black, and the car probably smelled like a little bit of weed, but it was nothing in the car.
Mm-hmm.
They searched the car. They brought all these canine units, and we were moving or whatever. So we were, like, already aggravated, whatever. So I'm sitting there in the corner because, you know, police hate when you stop. If someone's getting arrested at you, know, they'll tell you fast, get out of here.
Yo, go somewhere.
Yeah. So I'm just sitting in the corner hiding. So I just, they put him on the curb. First of all, they treat him like a straight up criminal for real.
Yeah,
they have him sitting on the curb. So after they searched the car, they were taking him off the curb. They dropped him. I hopped out the car so fast. Like, excuse me, what's going on?
Yeah.
Like, they tried to play it off like he fell, but his elbows were scraped up. Like, they threw it. I think they were mad that they didn't find anything.
Of course.
So they threw him on the floor. When I came over there with my phone, I was ready to record. Like, what are you guys doing? They tried to say, sorry, and try to make him agree that they just dropped him. And he wanted to just get out of there. So he's like, I fell. But of course they threw him. And I was ready to go crazy.
Oh, yeah.
And I told him, like, I want to write a report. I want to go to the police station. Mm-hmm. Like, I want to. So I think what I'm trying to say is it's going to take for people to stand up and voice what's going on. You can't be scared. Like,
exactly.
I'm not. a snitch or whatever you call it. But I want to go down there and say, you know what, you guys shouldn't treat every person like that. And he told me straight up, I pulled him over because he has this homicide hat, homicide Harper hat. And I said, well, I have a podcast or whatever. And we had the person that, you know, created the hats on our show. And it has nothing to do with violence. Right, like, exactly. I tried to explain that to him. Doesn't matter. He looked at me like, girl, you guys are criminals. He has that hat.
It doesn't matter. Like, exactly. So it's just gonna, that's the point I'm making right there. A hat.
Right.
It's a hat. I don't care what it say. It's a hat.
Yeah.
It's in my car.
Right.
You gonna pull me over because of what my hat say?
And then he said it,
so
too.
So what does that mean? Because does my hat saying this make you think I'm doing a crime?
Right.
Is that anything that is gonna get me pulled over?
Yeah.
That's not legal. You're pulling me over for my hat?
Yeah.
No, I'm gonna go now. Yeah. So you can pull me over for something else. Right. But not for my hat. That's not happening.
Exactly.
They were just, wow. Even him having money, like, we were about to go pay the security deposit. He had the money on him. They're like, why do you have, just going crazy. Like, we want to see, like, who's rattling around with their pay stubs? Why do I got to show you a pay stub right now? Just let me, you didn't find anything, so let me go.
Right. Like, I got a lot of bad stories with police like that. So I just, I got a gun pulled out on me for dropping my phone. You feel me?
What?
Yeah.
Luckily they just put it out on you. Right. They probably would have shot you.
He told us to get out the car.
Right.
I'm parked in my house with my boy. I was waiting, going to see my cousin and the baby.
Yeah.
He tells us to get out the car. He like, everybody put your hands out the window. My phone in my lap like this, sitting in the car. Everybody put your hands out the window. He got the bright light on us by himself.
Right.
We are in West Hartford.
Yeah.
Like behind like Marshall's, like that area up there. Like upper that's upper Albany, right?
Yeah.
So behind that area, like Flag Road, to be exact. That's what it is. And we in the apartment complex. He said he followed us. We watched him following us.
Yeah.
I'm like, yo, he think we smoking.
Yeah.
He just see four niggas in the car. He think we smoking. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to tell him I'm smoking. I'm going to light this Black and Mild right here that I just bought from the gas station just for this purpose.
Yeah.
And I'm going to light that shit up just so when you smoking, a Black and Mild.
Right.
Anything else?
Yeah.
He pulled up. That's what I did. Lit the Black and Mild. Sitting in the car, he put the bright lights on us.
Yeah.
Everybody put your hands out the window. So I put my hands out the window. I got a Black and Mild in my fingers, the hands out the window.
Yeah.
He's like, step out the car.
Yeah.
So I reached outside the car so we could still see my hands.
Yeah.
And I opened the car door.
Right.
He get out his car at the same time I'm getting out.
Right.
So I'm getting out. I turn my feet and my phone drop.
Yeah.
And he automatically, what the fuck is that?
Yeah.
Rush me, put me in the cuffs, all that. They stripped my boy car, tried to find some weed, couldn't find no weed. He ended up writing him a $400 ticket for cracking his windshield because he didn't find
it. Yep, same thing.
And then he tried to run my record. And at the time, that was my freshman year of college.
Yeah.
He ran my record.
Mm-hmm.
And my cousin was talking cash.
Yeah.
You fucking pig. Let him the fuck. My girl cousin.
Yeah.
Get the fuck off him. I'm like, Kiki, shut up. Like, you making this shit get worse, yo. He throwing me around. We get into the back of the car. I'm like, yo, why'd you arrest me? He like, oh, you a fucking tough guy. I'm like, I'm a tough guy. What are you talking about? Like, he like, give me your wallet. He look at my wallet. First thing he see is a University of Hartford school ID.
Yeah.
He was like, oh, you go to University of Hartford? I'm like, yeah, I'm a Barney School of Business major. And he was like, oh, you're a business major? I'm like, yeah, sir. He was like, no, let me run your record. Nothing.
Yeah.
Maybe it's not like that now. Freshman year when it was holy, I was good. Like, he ain't have no reason to be doing all that shit, but I have a lot more stories like that.
Yeah.
That's pushing me to make these records because it's getting worse, not just for me, but for everybody that's like me. You feel me?
That's a fact.
My little brother was raised in this world. I'm nervous to raise a kid in this world. Like, like, people, kids dying from police, like, not living full lives.
Over stupid shit.
Over nothing.
Luckily, it was one cop. But if it was more than one cop,
exactly,
they probably would have already shot.
Exactly.
By the time the phone dropped. Like,
exactly. So.
And that's crazy. Over a damn phone.
Over a phone. I know that don't sound like no gun. A plastic phone. Nah. I don't care what he say.
Yeah.
That don't sound like no
and
gun.
And then you see the way they talk to us off rip. Like, because I done got pulled over before, and cops, like, because I have tents, they'll get to the crime and be like, why the fuck were you speeding? Like, why, why are you talking to me like that?
Why?
Right.
So you just want me to react so you can have a reason.
Exactly.
You want to pull my reaction. So this is my reaction.
The music.
My records.
Exactly.
There you go. You can't stop that. And then when everybody starts singing it, I'm not inciting no riot. They chose to sing it.
Right.
We're definitely going to talk about that U-Heart situation.
Word.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But let's start from the beginning. From the blossom. From the bottoms.
Word.
Mike Flowz.
Mike
Flowz. Who are you?
I am the only Mike Flowz. Only alias King OVK. One verse killer. Raised Bloomfield, Connecticut, born in Hartford, Connecticut.
Before you continue, I like people that shout out their original location because people be like, yo, I'm from Hartford.
From
Hartford. But you gotta understand, CT is not just Hartford.
Right.
And a lot of people, all right, I wanna talk about that too, because that's crazy.
Go ahead.
I think that whole Hartford shit, the way people just see Hartford, they use that as like, like my back end. Like, yeah, I'm from Hartford.
Yeah, I'm from Hartford.
I'm from Hartford too, feel me? I used to live on Sigourney Street, all of that. But we moved from the hood.
Yeah, I
live in Bloomfield. I lived in Bloomfield the majority of my life.
Yeah.
But don't get it fucked up.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah.
Like, my dad didn't raise no punk.
Hell, my mother
didn't raise no punk.
Right.
Everybody want to be a thug. You claim that Harvard shit, I'm going to claim this Bloomfield shit. But when it comes to these, I'm not worried.
Yeah,
you feel me? Like, it is what it is. Yeah. That's me.
Yeah,
you feel me? That's what I'm saying. Really, it's just me. Yeah. I don't really get to, like, express how I really feel about it. Because I feel like anytime you say something to somebody, they just want to take it then.
Yeah.
You feel me? And if I don't want to... all it take is one thing to get me like this.
Yeah.
And I don't be trying to get myself like that. I'm about to be 23.
Yeah.
I'm tired of fighting. That's corny.
Yeah.
But that, I'm from Bloomfield.
Bloomfield.
Like, that's where the majority of my life was spent at.
Yeah.
Hartford, I know that, like, the ins and outs. I didn't venture off to the hood. I didn't been with my niggas in the hood. I didn't did. But that's not my life.
Yeah.
You feel me? People try to make that seem like, oh, this how I live. This what I do. I ain't no street nigga.
Yeah.
But you will get beat up like one night. That will happen.
Hartford is so small, first of all. When you can drive and be in Bloomfield, I don't even know you're in Bloomfield,
that's what I'm
first
saying.
Of all.
I live on the line. Like,
I just Blue found Hills. Out. Yeah. That's what I was about to say. I just found out, like, when you're going down Tower Avenue, what's that street? Like,
like
half of that street is considered Bloomfield.
Yeah. Yeah.
I
Coventry.
Just figured that out. Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. I never knew that.
I live right at the end of the cemeteries where all the gas stations live.
Yeah. That's Hartford.
Basically, it don't matter though.
It's
Bloomfield.
Hartford is so small.
To anybody else, that might matter.
Yeah, to you,
not to me, it don't matter. Right. To me, I live in Bloomfield.
So, growing up in Bloomfield, and what made you begin to rap? Like what inspired you?
Honestly, my biggest inspiration, other than my father, just coming in and out, having me freestyle in the car, because that's what he used to like to do.
Yeah.
But I used to be real big on Freestyle Friday.
Okay.
Like, take him in the basement, like them freestyles. I used to have to sneak to watch them, because when it got to a point, my mom used to hear some of the shit say to each other. It wasn't like, nah. So I used to be like, nah, I want to see that one. I got to watch this next battle.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I really got into that culture of just real bars.
Yeah.
And that's how I feel like really dudes really coming up with stuff on their mind, really having to use what their opponent, like not even making a story. You got to use your opponent in that. And I felt like, I'm like, I could do that too.
Yeah.
So I just started rapping about anybody.
Right.
Like, I was writing little verses. My first rap verse, my name Lil Mike, and I rapped nice and clear, the toughest thug, and I bit off Mike Tyson's ear. I wrote that shit when I was 7 years old.
For real?
Seven
years old. And I performed at my grandmother's party at church.
At church?
And she asked me to do it.
Yeah.
And my whole family went crazy.
Yeah.
But my inspiration then came from that. My grandmother, when she said, Mike, go ahead and rap. I want you to rap for me. And I'm at church dressed like Marshall Faulk. I got a Marshall Faulk jersey on, one jean leg up, rapping, talking. My whole family was feeling it. I'm like, yo, this is what I got to do. From there, I always dipped and dabbed with it.
Right.
Like, I always, because I'm music, I love it.
Yeah.
Like, I feel it. When I hear music, it can change my whole day. It can change my whole mood.
Right.
So I knew that's something I wanted to do.
Now, the question I have about that. You said you grew up off bars.
Yeah.
And this generation now ain't too much of that.
Exactly.
So do you think that's a reason why it's so refreshing to hear someone with bars come out the gate?
Yeah.
Rather than everyone sounding the same? Like, why do you... Because before, you had Nas, you had Jay, you had... The bars were there.
Yeah.
And then it kind of died down. So why do you think it changed so drastically?
I think... you just asking all the best questions. I think this is like... one of the part points of the game where it's become so saturated. And it's really saturated because what's being done is getting these niggas paid.
Point blank.
You can't hate. You got, like, as much as dudes, like, this new wave of rappers that's coming out, it's only three originals for this new, like, rock star rap sign.
Okay.
I'll get at the Future, Young Thug, and this little nigga Lil Uzi Vert.
Yeah.
Like, nobody really trying to turn up. Like, Rich Homie Quan and them in the middle, but they sound Southern. Like, you feel me? How they come off, they sound Southern.
Right.
Everybody else, like Lil Yachty, all these other new people, they come in with this, like, all this same sound.
Yeah.
But it's getting them paid.
You're right.
Like, people is listening to it.
Right.
They don't Uber everywhere, pre-rolls. If you can make a song and make four bars like that and you don't got to do nothing, it's going to get you paid, why the fuck I'm going to try?
Yep.
Why I'm going to try to think to make a record that I don't have to?
Right.
Because I'm touring around the world off of this right here, bro.
All these four bars.
But that's what I'm saying. They doing it more for the money. That's what, and you can't hate on that. In this game, mm-hmm. I don't want to do nothing for free,
yeah.
but I love music.
Yeah.
Like, I love the culture of rap. Right. Like, what really, like you said, Jay, Nas, Biggie,
yeah.
Big L, Rakim.
Oof.
Like, we naming, like, rappers. Yeah. You feel
rappers.
Me? Like, dudes that really do this. Like, back right. to Africa Being By. The Africa Being By wasn't talking about no stain.
I seen that picture.
Man, that's why
I seen that picture.
Word, I gotta throw him out there. He's going through some bullshit right now. Yeah. Maybe just be trying to defamate people's character. Yeah, yeah. I don't even care what nobody say.
Right.
But that's, like, I bet you if one of them cats right now
yeah.
had that experience, they wouldn't even know who that was. Like, if they was to look across the hallway right now, if they was to walk by, Africa Being By to walk by, these cats right now, they don't know who that is.
That's a fact.
They not listening to that.
That's a fact.
They listen in the future. They listen in to Young Thug. They yeah. listening to now. They listening to what's getting niggas paid.
Okay. So, follow-up question. I got questions. The questions be... Now, so, we're in this point in the rap game. It's all saturated. We got the futures and all that. How can someone like Mike Flowz make the impact that he deserves to make? Not what you think you need, but what you deserve to make.
I really feel like it's gonna... you just got to stay true to yourself. I really believe in myself. I really believe that if I stick to what I'm here for, because I feel like this is a God-given talent. Like
it,
I said,
is.
This is a blessing to me to be able to write a record, to be able to think about something that I don't like and like be the change you want to see in the world.
Right.
So, like I said, somebody going to have to be the person that's going to stand up and be the voice.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
If this is what I'm here to do, that's what I'm here to do.
Yeah.
I'm here to be that voice. Yeah. Like, and that's what I want to be. I'm going to just be original. And it's gotten me up to this point. I've lived in Bloomfield my whole life.
Mm-hmm.
I never moved anywhere. I never had no special connections. And I know for a fact right now that I could walk down the street, somebody be like, oh, you Mike Flowz?
Yeah.
Just to hear that, yeah. like, that's good enough.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm in my own town and somebody could recognize me in my own town.
Mm.
So that's good enough. If I keep being me and keep doing what I'm doing, somebody else from my own town gonna tell somebody else from a different hometown.
Mm.
And it's gonna spread like that.
Right.
Word of mouth is the fastest way to spread, other than the internet now.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
what. But yeah. originally, word of mouth
was the
that's what it get you to the internet, though. Yo, you seen that Vine?
Yeah.
Somebody talking to you, yeah. telling you what they seen, so... I just gotta stay true.
Yeah, yo.
People recognize real.
Yeah, you know what's crazy? Real. Yo, you sound just like your pops, yo. I swear to everything, yo. Hey, yo. I told you I was gonna do this, Davis.
Yeah.
I told you I was gonna do this, son. Shout out to Mr. Yo,
word.
That's
shout out
my dog,
yes,
yo.
Yes, sir.
I mean, you know all. You
no.
You cool with everybody.
Nah,
here,
for
right?
real,
yes, sir.
For real, for real, though. No, like, no bullshit, like. His dad is really like a role model of mine. Like, just
word.
The way he carry himself. Like, the first time I met him, he was like, what's good, man?
Da-da-da. Yep.
Always nice. He's dressed.
Yep.
He aimed. He be.
Mr. Davis. I know you from somewhere
else. His name is Mike Davis.
From somewhere else. I'm not, I gotta think about
his
it.
His dad is the real deal. His dad held me down at work, too, yo.
Yeah.
Yeah, we was in the.
Always. Yeah. We know POP.
Yeah. And the one thing I can say, yo, is I don't know his mom and his brother yet,
uh-huh.
but his dad to me. It's his biggest fan. Like, his dad, yo, the kids being in it, your dad put your music
yeah.
up, play the video, and they be like, yo, your son nice.
Yeah.
Your son nice. Da, da, da. He be like, yeah, my
yeah.
son is nice.
For real.
Yeah,
they know.
Yeah.
They know.
Real talk.
If they need me to come up there and throw some bars, I got that too. just in case.
Right. Shout out Mr. Davis.
Shout out my father.
Real talk. So,
for real.
So, what's up, man? Like, what's been going on with you?
Just this music.
Ah, that's
just,
it.
Like, I'm so focused.
Yeah,
I'm so focused. My next project, King OVK. I would say the release date,
please,
but I can't.
No,
you gotta drop that here. You gotta tell us.
You gotta give us the exclusive.
All right, I'm gonna give you the exclusive. I'm gonna give you the exclusive.
Okay,
because this is the projected date.
Okay,
You better not put that on Snap.
Okay.
Not yet, but this for them.
Okay,
September 4th.
September 4th. That's my
2016.
Birthday.
That's my birthday.
Really?
That's my 23rd birthday.
Hey,
it'll be the Jordan year. September 4th, my mixtape before that, Raw, dropped that on my birthday. Before Versace,
mm-hmm.
dropped that on my
that's
birthday.
That's gonna be a good date.
Everything that been
yeah.
dropped on my birthday.
Hey, yo, all I wanna let y'all know is I can't tell y'all what I heard.
Yeah.
Or the songs, but I could tell you. September 4th, you're going to be in for a treat, man.
Yes, sir.
A couple tracks he played for me. That might change the revolution of CT itself.
Yeah, right there.
No bullshit.
Right there, we trying.
And the good thing is you're aligned with the right people, too.
Yes.
You got, I know you be kicking it with Annoyed OD.
Yes, sir. It's my brother.
Shump.
That's my brother.
Ty.
These is my brothers.
Brody. It's a fact.
These is my brothers.
Real talk.
The like, winning circle.
The winning yes, circle. Before we get free loot, man. Free loot out the bang, man.
Free my fucking brother. Yo, I'm going to just look at the mic and say that. Free loot. Free loot, free loot, free loot, free loot. I'm going to say that. That shit is just crazy.
Yeah.
Because he's supposed to be here. He's supposed to be here.
Exactly.
The reason that I even got this little bit of buzz to come up, like I said, how people could be like, yo, you Mike Flowz? Yeah. That's because Luke was doing all my videos.
Mm.
Home came to me, yo, you nice, Mike. Yeah. Luke, Jeron used to rap.
Yeah.
Back in the day, he didn't have, Jeron was all.
Yeah, yeah.
Jeron was all. Everybody know that.
Yeah.
But he took a step back from the rapping, mm-hmm. picked up the camera.
Yeah.
He started making money from it. He mm-hmm. was getting shots, shoots, doing shoots, video shoots. Mm-hmm. I'm like, yo, you should do something with this. I had a show in Georgia, Making Georgia, and we ended up doing like a little vlog on YouTube, mm-hmm. Making Moves, M-A-C-O-N, Making Moves.
Yeah.
And we was down there, and that's when we came up with the name, Lavish Life.
Okay.
Throughout that, because it wasn't no name before. Mm-hmm. He was just Luke, and he was just doing his thing, you mm-hmm. feel me? He was like, yo, I'm going to come up with something.
Right.
I'm going to come up with something. I'm going to make it. That's going to be the name. And we was sitting behind the Applebee's. The funny story is we really thought we was about to get robbed because we was walking in the back skirts.
Yeah.
And we was just walking around, you feel me? Just seeing what it was like where we was at.
Yeah.
Told them to let my parents, I'm like, yo, you know we good.
Yeah.
Nobody ain't worried about no niggas.
Yeah.
When we got out there, it was a bunch of niggas out there. I'm like, we might have to be worried about the niggas. Yeah. Like, I don't know. So we walking through the back and he got his camera on, some chains on. I got my chain on. And I'm looking, I'm like, following us. We walk behind the gas station. They walk behind the gas station. I'm like, yo. He like, yo, pull right here. We stopped and stood on the wall. He put his camera up. He like, yo, whatever you want to do. I'm like, yo, just follow me, bro. Because you know. You already know. I'm like, yo, just follow me. And we sitting there right there. And the niggas walked around the corner. And they looked at us. They was like, hey, what up, folks? Said some whole country shit. And they just kept it pushing. Because it was some apartment complexes in the corner. And they just kept it pushing.
Yeah.
And I'm like, bro. He like, you my brother for real, yo. You my brother for real, my nigga. Because if that shit would have went down, it would have just been me and you back here.
Right, yeah.
And I'm like, yo, that's how it's always been, bro. Just me and you. He's like, yo, we need to do something with this. Yeah. And that's how we strengthen. Man, like, Lavish, like, I'm going to do your videos. We go back up there. We going to hit every song you drop. Anything you feel like you got a video for, you got an idea, hit me. We going to do it.
Mm.
And we just started dropping it. It's like, yo, got a little connection. Yeah. We did this, after I went to the Apollo, we did this Black Ranger when I hopped on the special delivery beat.
Yeah, yeah.
Because J. Cole and Lil Wayne did Green Ranger.
Right.
I did Black Ranger.
Yeah.
And when we did that video, we sent it to one of my mom's friends.
Mm-hmm.
And she texted her back like, when did Lil Mike get into a movie? That's what she said. She was like, how Lil Mike get in a movie?
Yeah.
She was like, girl, that ain't no movie. That's a music video. But just hearing that, and I told Jeron, I'm like, yo, this lady thought that shit was a movie, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I'm like, yo, we doing something, yo. Right. And we don't even got no real equipment. We got one camera and your computer.
Yeah.
Nothing else. We don't got no stabilizers. We don't got no drones. We don't got no big budgets for no settings. It's just me and you. And somebody thought I was in the movie.
Right.
We doing something. Yeah. And we was right here getting to the point where we was just going to keep going. And they just snatched it right away. It's like, yo, come in here, sit these 6 years.
Yeah, but he good though.
He good though.
He
good.
Yeah,
he's good. He done wrote me a couple times. He let me. Everything is good in there. He not hurting.
Yeah,
he not worried about nobody out here either. And I'm gonna say that for me. We not worried about nobody out here.
Word.
Anybody that think what they think about that situation, they don't know what the situation was. Nobody wasn't there.
Right.
You feel me? It was Jeron and him.
Yeah.
Let me just leave his name, but let him rest. But it was Jeron and him.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
Right.
Like, I was with both of them.
Yeah.
Like, them was both my bros.
Yeah.
You feel me? I done had relationships with both people involved in the situation.
Yeah.
I can't fault either one of them.
Yeah.
Like, it is what it is. They was both in the situation. That's how it ended.
Yeah.
Life got to go on.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You can't pick and choose. You got to pick your battles.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like, a lot of people would just be out here talking a lot of faulty on Jeron's name. Nobody had a lot to say. They didn't have all of that to say when he was out
here. Oh, yeah. And that's how it usually goes.
That never happens.
That's how it usually
like,
goes.
Like, I see all the tweets.
Yeah.
Niggas coming up. Fuck Luke. Come on, man. Just leave that. Because I don't even want to be that person.
Yeah.
Like, we don't even want to take it there because Jeron got more than just me as his boy.
Yeah.
It's more than just me.
Right.
We ain't, nobody don't want to have that. It's just want a free loop. We was out here trying to make money, do something positive. And that's all it is.
And when he come back, hopefully, I'm not gonna say hopefully. You gonna be another level
right here.
Exactly.
I'm gonna be up there,
and he gonna be right there with you.
I told him I'm gonna have something beefy, some big ass chain. Don't touch this shit. This shit just gonna stay on ice. When he get out, wrap that shit right on his neck. We straight. Let's get it.
Yeah.
Put home somewhere, cause he already know what he doing. I know he in there keeping his mind right. So
right, and that's all it is.
Free loop.
Yeah, free loop. FFC.
Oh yeah.
Fresh Food Crew.
Yes, sir.
I know. you surprised, huh?
Yes, sir.
You surprised, ain't you?
Yes, sir.
I'm walking. He like, yo, nigga, what you receiving?
Yes, sir. My butt. That's low key like Narwhal. Nigga just know already. He said the FFC. Hell yeah.
How did that start?
Yo, that literally started with me and my boy Tony.
Okay.
Tony Sutton. We were sitting in his basement.
Mm-hmm.
This was years ago.
Yeah.
Years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And we were sitting in his basement. And I'm like, yo, all these dudes out here got a name for their bros. Like, all these rappers with Taylor Gang, Mac, all these cats got clicks. Like, why don't we got nothing? Why are we just bros? Why y'all just come up to my show? We ain't screaming nothing. Yo, we got to come up with something. I'm like, we sitting there thinking, and I can't think of everything. We probably sat there for an hour.
Yeah.
Just talking.
Yeah.
His little sister came down, and we was just all sitting there just trying to think.
Yeah.
You know, just sitting back, and I'm like, Fresh Few. And they was like, Fresh Few.
Mm-hmm.
And they was just letting it rock. They was like, Fresh Few. And Alana, Tony's little sister, she was like, Fresh Few Crew, FFC. And I was like, yo, that shit sound, that, I like that.
Yeah.
I like that. And we didn't got to a point where we didn't seem creative. All right, one thing I will say,
okay,
at this newer stages of Double F, because it's always Fresh Few Crew. That's what it is.
Yeah.
But we didn't cut it down to Double F. That's why we scream Fresh Few.
Uh-huh.
But at one point, we were going to rock with this one thing,
mm-hmm.
and what it was designer, and it was spelled like DEZIGNR.
Yeah.
Basically, just to look at it like abstract, something that you would have to really look at it
mm-hmm.
to really read what that say.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like that explained me, like, as a rapper.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you really gonna have to listen to hear what he's saying, because it ain't gonna be no just off the top, like, oh, I get it. You gotta really listen.
Right.
Like, so, designer, I'm like, nobody don't really got that type of sound.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I feel like when I come on the record, I'm looking at it as a designer. Like, I'm trying to create something, you feel me? And what I'm doing when I'm creating it is in an abstract way. It's not easy. I'm not trying to do it like a four count, like I was saying, like just doing it to make money.
Yeah.
I'm trying to do it with a right up here, left down here, over here. I'm trying to bring in so many elements. It can't be spelled like designer. So we started saying that, designer season, Double F.
Yeah.
The reason we started saying that is because Double F, Fendi Gang. So designer, a designer, Fendi, it all blended.
Yeah.
That designer shit is dead. We cutting that out, because now we got designer out here. And that shit had me vexed. I want to say that on camera.
Yeah.
We had that name with this Fendi Gang a minute ago.
Yeah.
With Double F, with Fresh Few, that was supposed to be us.
Uh-huh.
But Double F still lives on. Fresh Few, we in here.
Exactly.
Fendi Gang, that will never stop.
And it's crazy. Like you said, he's rapping for years. Then this cool designer comes out.
Well, one track.
One track.
One track.
And the track wasn't even his at first.
It was his boys, right?
And now designers, the whole thought process is done. It's gone. It's out of here. So,
yep.
I mean, it still lives in spirit.
Yeah,
I gotta go and listen to his meaning behind designer.
Yeah, I want to know. I want to know about that, because I might have to really keep that going now, because I didn't explain the reason so people could understand.
I heard it was because he just knew how to dress.
Oh.
And he didn't want to keep, he had to put the extra I in there. Cause you can't just take the name designer. That's already patented.
Yeah.
You can't patent a name that everyone uses. So he just threw it up.
We're designers. Eye. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's what I don't know how true it is. Hopefully I get the show. Ask him one day. I don't know. So
ask him why he sound like Future too.
I know he probably say that from the beginning before he walk in. Like, don't ask me that.
Yeah, for real.
And that's the first thing I'm asking. Then you don't know. The questions you don't want me to ask is the ones I'm asking. So,
I thought that was a Future track. I used to be jamming like, yeah,
I was really hyped. I'm like, yo, Kanye got Future. I'm like, oh man. And then I just heard it too many times. I'm like, yo, that's not Future.
You exactly. Start listening like, yeah, I'm like, different.
It's a little thing on it.
But he got a lot of tracks that just.
Yeah.
It's like almost spot on.
Yeah.
Like, yo, you can really hear it. Like, damn.
Yeah.
That shit sound like Future.
Yeah.
It's this other dude named King. K-Y-N-G.
Is he nice?
He's Young Thug.
Oh,
Okay.
He just recycled.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm saying, if you go in his video, that shit got like 400,000 views or some shit like that, or whatever. Some crazy views. That's what's selling.
Don't sleep.
So wait.
So do you have anybody that's sounding like you? You think or trying to sound like?
You? I hope.
Of course.
I hope
there has to be
flattery. Yeah.
There has to be. This is
imitation
why
imitation is the biggest one. Flattery.
This is where. This is why it has to be someone that sounds like Mike Flowz.
Right.
Because he's been doing it for so long, and he's already made contributions to Connecticut. So, like, if you were to have a rap cypher, rap battle, he would be one of the people that you mentioned. So, you would research him and look, and then someone out of nowhere would be sitting here like, yo, damn, I want to know how to rap. And then pick him to dissect him. And then they might not sound exactly like him, but you can definitely catch the resemblance in the raps. So, and then there's another replica of Mike Flowz. They might not be doing it the best as him, but there's another one out there. Just like in the next couple years, there's gonna be another ACT Beauty, there's gonna be another Timeless Trail, there's gonna be another Jordan Rio. You know what I'm saying? It's just a trickle effect. But the game, the goal is to find them and bring them with you.
I swear to God, I was just about to say, well, if you find home, let home know we gotta do a track, because he out here with the same thoughts as me.
Exactly. You gotta find that person.
I was just about to say that.
Exactly. You gotta find that person, bring them with you, and show them the game. So even if you don't make it, God forbid, there's someone that at least look at Davies and Nas. Think of it that way. You know what I mean? Like on some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? There's some other things I want to touch on, man. I don't know which one I want to ask first. I don't know if I want you to get emotional right now.
Oh no! Nah.
Or if I want you to get, lit right now.
Either way, we gonna ride this roller coaster. So, whatever way.
First and foremost, I want to say, long live the Kid, Swagger Man.
Yes,
that's definitely my guy.
Long live.
He was definitely one of the first people when I said, "Yeah, I wanted to throw an event." Home was like, "Let's partner up and throw." And we threw a major successful event.
Yes, sir.
We didn't get to work again, but right before he passed away, I saw him at my mom's birthday party. He was at the Cloud. And he was like, yo, I see what you're doing with ReJuv'Nation. I want to get on here, whatever. And then to just see that happen, it kind of like tore a little bit out of me. You know what I mean? I was like, yo, I really sat down in the bed and I was just looking at God. I'm like, yo, God, like, why him out of all people? Like, him right there. You know what I'm saying? I just don't get it. Like, I just didn't understand.
It makes you feel bad, because even what he's reached out to me, I can go back to my inbox and I see all the times like, oh, we supposed to meet up, let's do this, let's work, let's promote. And then when that happened, I'm like, damn.
Yo, home showed so much love. It's ridiculous. If anyone out here says that Swagger was a hater, you're a hater.
Yeah.
Real talk, man. Because Swag showed love to everybody.
He was always everywhere.
Yeah. So
everywhere.
Let's talk about y'all connection, because I know y'all had a lengthy one.
Yeah, that was my man's. I met him when I went to UHeart.
Okay.
My freshman year.
Yeah.
And
definitely drop that story.
Yeah.
They want to hear it. They want to hear it.
All right. So, long story short, Hawk Hall.
Okay.
That's where the little...
Shout out to Hawk Hall.
Shout out to Hawk Hall. Because that is where it all started at right there. That's how I met the Money Team. Everybody, if I'm streaming Money Team, you already know what that is. Uh-huh. Everybody that was at UHeart at that time. But we had it. I was walking by with a couple of my boys. I really had just met them. But when we clicked up, they was in the same complex, the same type of people. And we was walking through, and I hadn't told them yet that I rap. You feel me? It was just, I knew it was gonna come. I'm like, yo, this is what I'm in college for. I'm about to network. I'm about to find somebody in here. I'm about to blow the fuck up at you. I'm thinking that. And that was the first, this is what I thought that was gonna happen. And there was a little rap cypher going on down the hill, right in Hawk Hall. And I'm looking for my complex as we walking by, and I'm looking, I'm like, yo, is they rapping? Because I'm putting my head down to like, listen, I'm like, yo, is they rapping in? I'm like, yo, they rapping. And he's like, yo, you spit? I'm like, yo, come on, man. Come on, let's come down here. So I let everybody get their shit off. It was Jay Reno. Shout out my boy Josh Casarino. He was a white boy that just, he was like Eminem.
Yeah.
But that shit was funny because he was so fast with it. Like Machine Gun Kelly, like all of them. We rap like that.
Yeah.
Shout out Josh Casarino, Justin Sketch. Home was kind of corny.
Yeah.
this dude, Problem, he was from Hartford.
Yeah.
He was tough.
Okay.
But I'll let them all get their shit off first. Because I didn't have nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
Feel me? I was just walking by and I'm like, yo, all right. Feel me? So they get down to the point. Oh, my boy Sam too.
Yeah.
He's a Q and he right. Oh my God. Well, Sam, that's my boy too. I forgot about Sam. But when it came down to me, feel me, I kind of like, let my shit level up.
Yeah.
Feel me? I kept my voice low until I really started getting into the verse where I knew I was about to be spitting that thick.
Yeah.
So I started getting my voice amped up. And niggas like, and I hear niggas in the background, and I'm the dudes that's with me looking around. Like, yo, yeah, this nice. After that, it's like, yo, what you go by? Mike Flowz. Where you from? I'm like, right here. What you talking about? Yeah. Right here. So my name spread from that.
Yeah.
Keith was big man on campus.
Uh-huh.
When I first came to campus, my name was Young Swag.
Okay.
I changed my name. Not even because of that, but his team was Team Fresh Young Swag, TFYS.
Uh-huh.
Feel me? I'm like, yo, that's crazy.
Yeah.
But I was changing my name anyway.
Right.
And we linked up because people with word of mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Like, who is Mike Flowz? Like, he like, yo, I heard about you, bruh.
Yeah.
I heard you spit.
Yeah.
He's like, I'll be doing some shows out here, be putting some shit together. Come spit. I'm like, yo, I'm 17.
Yeah.
He like, nah, come down to International. I'm gonna get you in there.
Yeah.
Feel me? We go down to International. Jared, Young Star, he was DJing. Funk Flex was DJing on this set too. Shout out Funk Flex.
Okay.
I need a bomb dropped on this. I need that. But he just got me in.
Yeah.
Long story short, he got me in. I wasn't supposed to be in there, but he got me in. And I had a whole performance of like 20 minutes.
Damn.
The longest performance that I had.
Dang, right.
I was going in like, yo, this shit feel amazing.
Yeah.
Like being at this club, mm-hmm. after that, he was just like, yo, you're something different.
Yeah.
Like your sound, like you rapping. He was like, y'all knew you was tough, feel me? But seeing you, like, don't, this shit different.
Right.
He approached my parents, came to me, like, yo, I don't got nothing but a dream, bro.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you live in the same way.
Right.
You know, we in college together. Like,
right.
We don't got nothing but a dream right now.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you right.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, but I really feel like with the shit that I do around here, like I could manage you.
Mm-hmm.
And feel me? We just never got into it. We never got to meet up. But it was never like that wasn't my man's.
Yeah.
Cause he did a lot of shit after that. Like, yo, come through here. Come right. through here. This right. happening. He put on the last thing he did, he put on the show for me and Annoyed
mm-hmm.
with his girlfriend
yeah.
at the time. And we performed at Burger Baby downtown.
Yeah.
It was just our show. Right. Us three.
Yeah.
So that shit, I'm like, yo, that was a big move. He got this whole shit and we just down here.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, we could have told anybody to come through.
Right,
like, that
right.
was our show.
Yeah.
And he really just did that shit off the strength. That I really fuck with you. You really nice.
Mm-hmm.
I believe in you. So come through.
Right.
It was another show, the Valentine's Day special. I wasn't 21.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't supposed to be able to get into there. He got me into there to perform this song that I did with Perry Mack.
Okay.
And we performed there. And he was just, that was my man's. Like, he always showed me love. That was never somebody I thought would go like that.
Yeah,
never in my wildest imagination would I think somebody would be like, yo, Keith crashed.
Yeah.
Like, what?
Yeah.
Are you serious, bro? Yeah. Like, he don't even seem like he drive like that.
Right,
you feel me?
Yeah.
Like, his personality so bubbly, he's so happy, he's so much love, he's such a sweet person.
Yeah.
I would never think that he would be speeding like that, but it just, that shit was just crazy.
Right.
And like, this next mixtape, that whole day,
yeah.
I talk about that in that song. Like how you said.
Yes.
Yeah, that whole day.
Listen, don't drop the bomb.
I'm not gonna drop the bomb.
Just
but
know.
I'm gonna let them know. It's a lot of emotional shit on there, a lot of real life shit. Like how you said.
Right.
When thinking about Keith, like the type of person he is, like you was asking, like, why?
Right.
Like, why him? Like, why that way?
Yeah.
That's how I was. And I felt like I was a little bit angry.
Yeah.
Just thinking about it, because I done lost a lot of brothers, bros that I call my men through my niggas. Like, I know them. It's more than just some, yo, I see them and say what up type shit.
Exactly,
it's some shit like I had a connection with each and every one of these people
in
some way, shape, or form.
Mm-hmm.
And they all got out of here with some car.
Right.
With a car. My boy, the first person that ever got hit with a car, that my boy Anthony Morales, Swagmore.
Yeah.
And that's when I really started really rocking with that Young Swag shit, because that was my boy.
Yeah.
Swagmore. And our birthdays was the same. When I met him, 9493.
Yeah.
And he came to Bloomfield, and we just clicked up like that. I'm like, yo, that's my twin. That's a twin, feel me?
Yeah.
We was going everywhere together. Then he rap, I rap. Yo, I feel like he was only in school. He could have only been in school like 7 months.
Yeah.
Before that shit happened. Like, I felt like I didn't have no time with him.
Yeah.
Like, that was just my bro, and he was just gone.
Yeah.
Like, we talked about doing so much shit as we got older.
Yeah.
He was my bro, and my just gone.
Yeah.
Next, Jamar. That was my little big brother.
Yeah.
My big little brother, actually, because he was small. He was younger than me, but
he was big as hell.
He was the bear.
Right.
Feel me?
Yeah.
But he changed his whole, when he first came up here, he came to Bloomfield, and I worked with him hand to hand when we was playing football.
Yeah.
My father, he was coaching on the B team.
Right.
And Jamar was a clown.
Yeah.
I was a clown.
Yeah.
But I was older. I was already on the team. Yeah. I knew what to do.
Yeah.
So me and Jamar, yo, you gotta do this. He was with me the whole time.
Yeah.
He took that football shit and went. I ended up backing out of football. He took that football shit and just
to another level.
That was me.
Yeah.
And when I seen, yo, when he got low and went MIA so he could train and get start lifting. The next time I seen him, his chest was like my head. That shit was like, his shoulders was big. I'm like, Jamar, goddamn, bro. And he's still a clown. Like, yep. He's just doing some clown shit.
Yeah.
But everybody know Jamar just loved to drive fast. He loved his car. He put a lot of money into his car. He put a lot of fast shit in his car to make his shit go fast.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how he went.
Yeah.
He told somebody, man, I love my car so much, I'm going to die in my car.
That's crazy.
Straight up. And that's really how he went.
Yeah.
He's like, I might die in my car. Yeah. I love this shit.
That's crazy.
And that's really how he went. Right. And that shit was so random. Like, that was my brother. Like, Jamar, I see you everywhere I go. He be like, man, battle me. I got some bars for you, right? Battle me.
Yeah.
He do some push-up, nigga. get your chest up. Like, anything. Yeah. That was my bro.
Yeah.
And he just went like that.
Yeah.
That shit happened so many times. Like, do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And it was, at that point, when Keith hit, it was like another situation. Like, this is just it's too sweet of a person.
Yeah.
It's like niggas that's going, that's not doing no wrong.
Right.
Feel me? Everybody's a sinner.
Yeah.
Nobody not living perfectly.
Right.
But it's niggas out here that's living with morals that's going.
That's what I say, like, all the time.
You out here, you really living with morals. Like, you not living immorally. You not living wrong.
Mm-hmm.
You might be doing wrong, but you not living wrong.
Right.
Feel me?
Right.
And you going. That shit just make me question. But that, what happened in my situation, that was a wake-up call. You feel
Definitely.
Me? Like, you don't question God for nothing.
Definitely.
It happened. What happened with
life
you?
Happened. Oh. I crashed my Acura.
That was the song.
I crashed the morning I found out about Keith. Like, that's what I'm talking about in that whole song. I don't even got a name for it, so that's why I could talk about it.
Yeah.
Right. But in that whole day, I woke up early in the morning and I found out that Keith passed. And that same night of that day, I crashed and flipped and totaled my Acura. I flipped my car.
Yo, his father showed me the picture. I was like, yo, I have no idea how he even made it out of that car. That shit looked so crazy.
Yeah.
And then especially to think that your friend earlier, you
not
know,
even
didn't make it.
Yo, his father was, he was like, yo, all I know is he called me. He was like, yo, I crashed my car. He was like, what the fuck?
Yeah. Da, 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 da.
Ran down there. He was trying to explain the story. He wasn't trying to hear it.
Yep.
Then he wanted to see the car. He said once he seen the car, he was like, all he could do is come back and give him a big ass hug.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's
that's exactly how it was. And the real reason it was a wake up call, because the truth of the matter is, like, I'm not gonna lie about this story.
Yeah.
Like, factually, it wasn't nothing involved other than just me getting randomly sleepy.
Yeah.
Like, I don't understand how that shit happened.
Yeah.
I don't know why it happened. Yeah. I've never ever dozed off behind the wheel.
Yeah.
Never even felt like I was getting tired. Yeah. Never in my life.
Yeah.
But earlier in that day, like I said, I was really looking at life angry.
Yeah.
Like, this shit fucked up. Niggas just be here and dead. Like, that shit can happen to anybody. Like, that's crazy. And I'm really just, like I'm saying, like, to myself, like, questioning God, like, why? And coming up in the church, you don't question God for nothing. Life happens.
Mm-hmm.
It is what it is. He took him home for a better purpose. That's what I'm supposed to think. But that day, I wasn't thinking about it like that.
Right.
And when I flipped my car, I hit a telephone pole. I flipped, landed on the hood, and I crawled out the side of my car. And when I stood up, I was standing in front of my church parking lot.
Wow.
Literally in front of my church parking lot. Nowhere else, not far, not down the street. Right to the left side was my church parking lot.
That's
my whole entire church. And I was just standing there looking.
That was like God talking to you.
And that's what I said. I was just standing there looking. And I'm looking at myself. And I'm touching my face. And I'm looking. And I'm like, bruh, I'm straight.
Yeah.
And I looked down at my leg. And my shit was wide open. And I'm like, all right. I don't feel it, though.
Yeah.
I'm straight.
Yeah.
I'm looking back at my car. And I smell the fucking fumes and the dust. I'm like, I'm really straight.
Yeah.
Ran to my boy house. Called the police. I'm like, yo, dad, I crashed the fucking car. And my mother answered the phone. She like, what, Michael? She thinking, I'm like, yo, I crashed the car. Come up the street. And then she heard the police sirens. Everybody in Bloomfield, the power went out somewhere.
Yeah.
And they pulled up. My mom was just looking. Because I came running back around from behind the church.
Because
I went to my boy house. My phone, I ain't have my phone.
Yeah.
Come running back around the church. I'm floor and I'm looking like, yo, because I don't want them to be like, yo, he left the scene and arrest me when I get back there. I'm like, no, I'm trying to get back here, bro. Trust me. I'm running back. And once I got there, one of the police officers, Officer Thomas, used to work in my school, a lady. And she just seen me and was like, Michael, this was you? Like, oh my, and everybody just hugging me like, yo, are you okay? And I'm like, yeah, I'm good. It's just my leg. And they wrapped my leg up and my mom just looking like, what the fuck, Michael? And the reason that I got both of them songs on there, in the first song I heard you that you said gonna be some revolution shit. My mother is sitting here, I'm standing here freezing. I got on shorts and a t-shirt and my leg is still gushing, like wide open. And I'm sitting there on the curb and my mom like, do y'all need us to bring him to the hospital? Because the paramedics is on the other side. I don't know what they was doing. To this moment, I still don't know what they was doing. And the officer looked at my mother like, ma'am, if you don't calm down, I'm going to ask you to leave. All stern. I'm like, yo, don't fucking talk to my mother like that. I'm like, ma, don't even say nothing to him because you already seen all these videos with these cops. I said that shit in his face. I said that shit in his face just like that. I'm like, you already seen all these videos with all these cops. Don't even say nothing to him. I'm like, yo, had the paramedics hurry up, bro. Because my mom could bring me. And he like, oh, no, we're just making sure. I'm like, y'all not making sure nothing. Because you done told my mom she got to leave. Nigga, I almost died, bruh. You see my car. Y'all talking about y'all pulled up looking for bodies. Y'all looking for bodies to see who flew where. What? Then you going to tell my mom she got to leave? Because she going crazy because she see me right here now? No, bruh. You lucky I ain't slapped you. Lucky we ain't get to there. Because that's my mother and she's in a state like me. She's spooked. Look at my son's car. After I just told her story, I called her. We was on the phone for like 20 minutes. I'm like, mom, you remember Keith? And she like, and I'm telling her the whole story and I'm talking about Fresh. I'm like, remember Fresh and remember all them? I'm like, Fresh just called me and said, keep dying. And we was on the phone. She like, Michael, I'm telling you about that car, them cars. Y'all driving too fast. And we had that whole conversation. So I know once I crashed in that same 24 hours, like, that was too much for her. You ain't going to do that to my mother. Man.
Like, can't no one do to mom.
But your mom, she probably didn't, like, she's talking to yourself. You having a full conversation. I know she's not thinking that the car was that crazy. If you could talk to her like that. So when she got there, that's probably when she really went.
That's exactly what it was.
Yo, real talk,
though. That is exactly what it was.
I'm just happy that you're here.
Yes, sir. Me too. Real talk. I am happy that I'm here.
Real talk.
Yes, I am.
Next one. 93 to infinity. I know.
Yes, sir.
I know that's so.
Yes, sir.
Let's talk about it because I hear 93 to infinity. I play that they remember. I'm like, all right, so let's go into substance about that.
All right, 93 till infinity. Till infinity will to this day. Currently, I don't care what happened with this. Whenever I decide to do an album, that's what it's going to be called, 93 till. So I'm basically promoting my album
throughout the whole story.
My whole story. So whenever I decide this gonna be my first album, I'm gonna put a project together and call it an album. It's gonna be 93 Till. Basically, 93 Till came from the fact that, like, I only listen in my only real musical influences that guided me to start rapping was 90s niggas. It was J. Cole, it was a whole bunch of people. Not J. Cole, I'm talking about Nas, Jay-Z, but I'm saying now. I feel like that's who really implement that, like that real hip hop feel, that real, the real deal. You feel me? That came from the 90s. I was born in 93. So from 93 till my music gonna live forever. That's what it's just gonna be.
That's lit.
I like that.
You see how it's just crazy? Like, you gotta, it's kind of like you gotta make it.
Yeah.
You feel me? That makes sense. Like, you've been through so, you have to make it. You gotta make it. Like,
I gotta make it.
There's no way around it. It's like, if I would have ever looked 10 years down, they'd be like, yo. They'd be like, yo, Mike Flowz is the president of the USA. I'm like, he still ain't where he's supposed to be at. He still ain't where he's supposed to be
at. I'm not supposed to be
there. You're not supposed, you're supposed to be a rapper. That's changing lives. Yes. Man. For real.
Yes. For real. Shit.
Now, you perform, you open up for French and T.I.
Yes, sir.
Heard that was super lit.
Yo, it was super lit.
Yeah?
It was super lit. Shout out to my man Drewski, man. I got to shout out DJ Drewski.
Yeah, bro, he killed it.
Yo, that's another person. Every time I go somewhere, that nigga believe in me too.
Yeah.
He didn't let me know straight up, Mike, you hard. We got to do this. We got to do that. And now we done got on some shit. We didn't actually did one of my sets before. Now we going to take that shit somewhere else.
Yeah.
So, but that's it with, yo, I'm telling you, when we was looking out the crowd and we was waiting, it was this band on before us. Yeah. It was just blowing my thing, but it was on for mad long. Like, damn, son, this band, they done got 13 songs. They don't know these songs. Yeah. Yo, they not French and T.I. Yeah. Let us get on. Yeah. But they got on. They got them lit. The little segment they got. If we would have had it, like they had it last year, because the year before, because I went to You Heart Lab. Yeah. I mean, I went to the Spring Fling last year. I ain't performed.
Yeah.
And that shit was crazy. It was at nighttime.
Yeah.
Juicy had his baseball jersey on, his name on the back. Yeah. That shit was lit. It was like, it was mad turn. I'm like, yo, next year, bro, I'm going to make sure I'm performing.
Yeah.
I'm going to make sure. I'm going to do something. I'm some way. And from that point, I'm like, yo. And then it got down to Spring Fling. I'm like, oh, yeah. I lost my whole train of thought. And it took me like 2 weeks. I just texted everybody I knew. I'm like, yo, what's up with it? What's up with it? What's up with it? What's up with it? Using anybody, all my connections, anybody I knew. And eventually they was like, yo, come here at this time. Just come with some shit.
Yeah.
I'm like, yo, you know. We get on the stage. Juicy introduced me.
Yeah.
And I come out. You feel me? I'm just looking at the crowd. You feel me? And I'm thinking, I'm like, yo. And I'm thinking in my head, at the last minute, I promise you. Because the whole time, I'm like, man, yeah, I'm a rock it with this. Wait till they hear this shit, this revolution music. Wait till they hear this shit. At the last moment, I'm like, yo, I should have switched my set. I'm like, yo, I should have had the fucking little female songs in the beginning just to get some time. So they would have had to let me finish that last one. But I got to it. And after they said it was the time. Yeah. They said it was because somebody had pulled up. Maybe. Yeah,
maybe.
Maybe.
We'll never know.
But I feel like, yo, as aggressive as they kicked us off, like, it wasn't like no, it wasn't no warning. Yeah. Like, my song just went off and it was just like, that's it.
That's
messed up. I couldn't even say nothing to the crowd. Like, yo, he walked up to me, give me the fucking mic. And I'm looking at him like, yo.
Did they make you pay to open up?
No.
So the man cut your shit off, came and said, give me the fucking mic, and kicked you up
straight like that.
It wasn't because nobody pulled up.
When I walked to the side, though, the artist was standing right
there.
Yeah. I forgot his name. Bryce.
Bryson Till?
No, not Bryson Till. I know that. Bryce Vine.
It don't even matter. I bet you if you kept rapping, Bryce would have been like, yo, that shit hard.
Yo, and I'm trying. That's what I'm saying. They let me get through it. In the next song I had, I was literally doing the introduction for it.
Yeah.
And I walked back to Juicy because he threw out some t-shirts and he trying to be calm and he telling me, he like, yo, they cut this shit. And he talking to me like that. He like, yo, I don't even know what to say.
Yeah.
And he trying to, and on the video, on my boy video, I ain't noticed because I got my head linked like this.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yo, what? You serious?
Yeah.
They about to cut this shit.
Yeah.
And he was like, yeah, bro, I don't even, yo, just pick this shit up. Just take the mic off. And I turned around right here and the big dude was right there with his hand on the mic like this. He's like, give me the fucking mic. And I'm like, yo, you serious? Like, I'm like, yo, I can't say nothing. He was like, nah, you're done. Straight like that. And I'm like,
can I say thank you?
That's what I'm like, yo, I can't even say thank you. I can't say nothing. All right, yo, just take the mic. And
I must say, I promoted shows too when we have opening artists, like for the setup for the rappers or whatever, and we do cut people time.
Yeah. I know.
If they get there and if the main artist change their mind, they want to go on early, we cut that
but
show.
But this is my thing, though. If you promote something and the crowd is rocking with it,
you gotta
let that shit marinate for a little bit.
I didn't even get the. I'm like, yo, they was really rocking. Like, I'm looking at the video. They was getting to the point because I'm fresh. Like, they don't know me.
Yeah.
I'm opening up. Like, it's not like everybody just going to be cheering.
From the moment you start. You got to let it rock.
Yeah.
Who is this? But I was getting to that point, I had got to start rapping.
Yeah.
And I was getting people to get walking to the stage and they like, all right, let me listen now.
Yeah.
All right.
Then they snipped your
Then
shit.
I'm getting to it, getting up.
Yeah.
Nope. Right when I was about to get everybody hooked, I had two tracks. One track that's on King OVK.
Because
I be performing
some
of the songs just to see the type of reaction to get.
Yeah.
Feel me? But I had one song that's going to be on King OVK. That's, I'm going to just leave that unnamed that I was going to perform.
Uh-huh.
But I was going to end with Lambo music. And I ain't even get to my, that's like my most turnt song for me.
Yeah,
like
when
I hear that shit and perform it, like I just be so turnt.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
And I ain't even get to it. I knew just based off my energy, it would have raised the energy up. But
I mean, that just mean that when you drop the mixtape, that you got to have something special for it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And just know, ReJuv'Nation will be there.
Yes.
For sure.
Yes.
Right.
That's kind of funny.
Yeah.
But
we
ain't.
Are you doing it on your birthday? You gonna do a party on your birthday?
Yo, chill. Don't.
I'm sorry.
Film, you know the construction pieces. Yeah. You know, you got like a 500 piece puzzle and you only got like 250 right here. You gotta sort these out. And two, you gotta sort them out, make sure.
Yeah.
And put it all together.
That's like Labor Day. That's gonna be.
Boy. That sound like it's gonna be. You feel me? You know, yeah. I've been thinking.
Right.
Feel me? I got a plan for everything. It's a blueprint.
Yo,
Jay-Z voice.
I'm gonna say this. I'm gonna say this right now. I really believe in you, bro.
Yeah.
Nah, like, no bullshit. Like, when your pops gave me this CD, I did him the favor. Like, I'm gonna just listen to it.
Yes.
And literally, like, I listened to one track. I'm like, yo, this shit all right.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, I'm like, yo, three, four. I'm like, oh, shit. And now it's like, I can't go through a day. Like, that shit's just in my shit. Just if it ain't Ace. It's
yes,
you,
sir.
Bro. Real talk.
Yes,
so, at the end of the day, I really, really, like, ReJuv'Nation really backs you.
That's love.
Nah, for real.
Love,
so,
real shit.
At the end of the day, whatever we could do for you, man, let us know.
This is enough right here. Just giving me this platform to talk and be able to speak my mind and talk about the shit that I see. That's enough right there.
Yeah. I see you. Did you massage your mic?
I did. I took my hand down because I'm like, you're not about to talk about me. When you watch it back, you're going to see my hand up.
Take that shit down.
But before you looked at me, I went like this.
Word. Now, before we wrap it up, I always ask the guests, like, something that you just live by, like something when you wake up, you be like, yo, like this just me, like a motto, a quote, anything. Like, what do you like live by to listen to?
To be totally honest,
yeah.
As of recently, I've been waking up every day just thinking I gotta get to it. Like, I don't, it's not even no motto no more. Like, how, you know how people got like little, like you said, like little quotes?
Yeah.
To me, right now, it's just, yo, get to it.
Right.
Whatever that means,
yeah.
For this day, get to it.
Yeah.
Get to it.
Get it done.
Get
it's
it done.
Simple, but that
means
a lot.
That do mean a lot.
Don't steal it.
Hey, yo, I'll be patting other people's shit.
Nah.
Yeah.
That's love.
That's love. It's great. I'm going to say that shit all
he
day.
He acts these quotes every time. But real he writing them down. I'll be
trying this shit down, put them on marriage.
Straight up. Get to it.
Now, social media, where can people find you?
Mike Flowz, FFC. Mike Flowz, FFC. That's on Instagram. That's on Twitter. We're going to search YouTube. That's just Mike Flowz. Okay. SoundCloud is just Mike Flowz.
All right.
Google is just Mike Flowz.
Okay.
Yo, that shit is... Yo, I love that. Yo, I used to do that shit when I was in middle school. Yeah. Try to, like, Google my rap name and see what pop up. And nothing would pop up.
Nah, I had to you got a whole lot. I Googled
16
you.
Pages. Yeah. I have to go to, like, page 16 before I see one little JPEG. Yeah. Little ass scrunched up picture.
Yeah.
But now... I type my name in, I can see something.
In.
Like, feel me? Yeah, it's going.
Word.
I gotta make it.
Exactly.
I have to.
Yo, one more big shout out to Big Davis, man.
Yes,
you
sir.
My guy, man. I'm gonna see you tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
My homie.
Yes, sir.
it's your boy Thomas Trell, man, here with A60 Beauty.
Thanks for coming.
Thanks for having
me. Got the magnificent Mike Flowz in the building.
Yes, sir.
And you're tuned into the RJN Sessions at ReJuv'Nation.com.
Connecticut, 187, fuck a pig, a Confederate. B.I.C. mean the best in the country. I go bananas, you call me a monk. B.I.C. mean brother in color. That's word of my mother. Do this for my brother. There is no one other. Spot under covers, that's homos or popo. Y'all both is some suckers. All I wanted was a Lambo. Black on black, the red brake pedals. In the spot for me to keep the bands low. Cooler seats when the black is out, cause a nigga always got his pants low.